Hey guys, this is Mr. Mavenite 6 more, my little Dashie. This is gonna be the last part of this dramatic reading. This is part 3. If you wanna read along, the link is in the description. This is in the same recording section, the same recording session as the last two parts, and it's currently 2:36 a.m. I still have no idea why I'm still up. I guess I just wanted to get this out of the way because I'm afraid that I won't have enough time to record tomorrow, or today, I guess. Oh, it's so confusing. Let's just get this over with so I don't have to hurt my brain before I go to sleep. Anyway, guys, here we go, Milo Dashie. There's a point in every parent's life when they have to let their child go. Whether it be for the better or for the worst, it must happen at some point. I now sit here in my living room by myself, sulking over photographs of my distant memories of me and Dashie. On her 20th birthday, I had planned a special outing to go see a flight show. As we prepared to leave, there was a knocking at the door. Never in the years we had lived there had anyone knocked on the door. Heck, we hadn't even made arrangements if somebody did show up. I simply told her to go to her room while I took care of it. Once I heard her door shut, calmly and collectively, I asked who was knocking, expecting some stranger possibly lost on his or her travels. A female voice spoke in such an elegant, yet attention-grabbing tone, I felt myself listening to her with the uttermost attention. She asked if she may come in, a question I'd normally refuse within a heartbeat, yet something was about her voice was reminiscent. I couldn't help but walk over and open the door. When I first saw the figure standing on my porch, I wasn't sure if I was dreaming or hallucinating. Standing there was the majestic Princess Celestia. I was at a loss of words, fighting both emotions of brony excitement, which I had only felt when I first found Dashie, and emotions of sorrow, for I knew what this meant. She stood there, another second looking at me. We matched each other in the eye level, and her body size being the size of a nearly fully grown horse. I stepped back and allowed her to enter. What caught me off guard next was the five other ponies that followed suit. First Twilight Sparkle, then the rest of the gang. Applejack, Rarity, Fluttershy, and lastly Pinkie Pie bounced in. Ooh, so this is what an alien house looks like. On the inside. Oh my, you have a kitchen! I'm starving. Are you starving? I can make us some. She was stopped by Applejack's hoof. Easy there, Sugar Cube. We're just here for Rainbow Dash, so we ain't got no time for an eating. Applejack's stomach growled. No matter how hungry we are. I still wasn't sure of how to completely react to all this, but not wanting to be rude, I offered some leftovers. We have some leftovers from dinner last night. You're more than welcome to some. Pinky took that as an okay and ran into the kitchen with much vigor. It seemed I did not even need to tell her where anything was. She instantly knew where everything was placed. Factored to either dumb luck or just simply being Pinkie Pie. I chose the latter. I'll go keep an eye on her, Applejack said, walking to join the Hyper Pony. As she passed, she tipped her hat to me. I was finding it odd the ponies were not more hesitant around a creature such as me. Then again, the same could be said for myself, but having Dashie for 15 years, I grew to having such a thing around me. Now, I have five of their ponies and a full-sized goddess horse looking at me with the same amount of curiosity that I had held for them. There was a moment of silence as I watched the two mares enter my kitchen and begin to rummage through my fridge. I'm quite surprised, Celestia began. I had expected a little more resistance to us entering. Why, I know who you all are. Celestia nodded. Ah, so you do know, then? That you're fictional characters from a children's TV show, then yes. Otherwise, why you are here, I have no clue. The last part I lied, hoping to keep my mind at ease. I knew the reason, but I wanted to ignore it. Oh, I think you do know. My heart fell into the pit of my stomach. I did know. And she was straight to the point about it. During all these years, I had anticipated this moment, but As time drug on, that idea slowly dispelled until it was nothing more than just a minor nip in my mind. That's when it always happens, you know. When everything is finally perfect and you don't have to worry anymore.
Excuse me, sir,
Twilight began. But from what we could figure out, Rainbow Dash should be here. Is she? I looked at the purple mare. I wanted to tell her no, but it was all... But I knew it was fruitless. She's upstairs in her room.
In her room?
Rarity asked, surprised. Yes, Dashie's in her room. I wasn't sure who was knocking, and I didn't want her to be spotted.
Dashie, my. You're that friendly with her already.
Rarity continued. I wanted to punch that pony so hard right then, how she responded insulted me.
Friendly? That's not even the beginning of it. I should be asking you ponies as to what the heck you did.
Cecilia raised a brow, taken back by my change of tone.
You see, my student.
I know who she is. Get to the chase. I was very short with her. As furious as I was, I wanted to know why they'd send Dashie to as a filly to some of the world. Twilight bit her lip as her teacher continued.
Yes, of course. Ahem. She was working on a spell to help the weather team with some storm development. Well, they made slightly too big a storm, and when Twilight used her magic to try to dispel it, it shot a lightning bolt, meeting a magic.
Rainbow Dash was unfortunate enough to be within reach of the blast. It had engulfed her and sent her to, well, here. So, we are here to retrieve her. Simple enough, I'd imagine. Before I could answer, Dashie called down from her bedroom.
Dad! Is everything all right?
My heart stopped beating as I looked from pony to pony. Each one's face was in pure shock and confusion. They recognized the voice of the Rainbow Dash, but she said, Dad.
Excuse me, Shurcube.
Applejack started, returning from the kitchen.
Did I just hear Rainbow Dash call you Dad?
Before I could answer, Celestia started up again.
Do you care to explain?
I was lost. So many things were running through my mind at once. There was only one thing I could do, and I had to do it. But I knew I wouldn't like it. Go into the living rooms and make yourself comfortable. I'll be right down with her. I didn't allow a response. I turned around and walked up the stairs slowly.
Dad?
Yeah, Dashie, I'm coming up. I looked back down into the group of ponies as they watched me ascend. We need to talk. So that's what I told her who was down there, and that they were there to take her. She had seen the cartoon every so often after some time, and found the wacky adventures entertaining. She had given up any thought that the Rainbow Dash in the show was her, and only viewed it as another cartoon. As I talked to her, explained that those very ponies she didn't believe in were downstairs. She brushed me off with some laughs. She didn't believe me and thought I was playing some joke on her. So I took her down into the living room.
Dashie!
Pinky shouted, jumping onto her cyan friend. Dashie was quick to shove the pink pony off.
Hey, get away from me!
She was taken back by the sudden amount of ponies filling our living room. They all looked to her with worried expressions as to why she shoved her closest friend away.
Pinky's cotton candy mane went straight
as she looked in confusion.
You don't remember me, do you?
No, or any of you,
Dashie continued. It hurt me in so many ways. I knew these were her friends, but so many things have happened differently that she doesn't know the truth fully. Neither did they, so I had to explain to them.
I started. Dashie,
take a seat, please, so I can talk to them. She did just that in her recliner. The entire time, she looked at all the ponies who occupied the couches and center rug in front of the fireplace. It was time, but first I had to start with a question.
How long ago was she sent over here?
The question caught them off guard, but Twilight cleared her throat as she spoke.
About 15 days ago. Why?
Well, it's been a lot more time than that here. I skipped a part. I was speechless.
15 days ago? She's been with me for 15 years. That means a day in their world meant a year here.
Well, I continued, it's been a lot more time than that here.
How long?
Twilight asked. 15 years. All the ponies besides Celestia's had their mouths agape.
That don't explain why she don't know us, Applejack said.
Well, that's the thing. When I found her, she was a filly.
Come again?
From my math, I think she was no older than 4 or 5 years old.
Now Celestia looked surprised. You mean to tell us that you've been taking care of Rainbow Dash for 15 years since she was a small filly? She asked.
I simply nodded and looked over to Dashie, who wore an expressionless look on her face. I started, but I couldn't hold back any longer. I know it's not true. I wish it was, but I understand. The dad now makes sense. Celestia cut me off, holding a stern look about her face. She was thinking, trying to piece together in her mind what could possibly have happened. I chalked it up to the magic. Being unstable probably reverted her in age. For a few moments, it was quiet, besides the breathing of 7 ponies and myself. Finally, it was Dashie who broke the silence.
So, what's supposed to happen now?
I looked at the princess, trying to read her face. No matter how good I had gotten at reading Dashie's face, Princess Celestia had been the best poker face I had ever seen. I had no clue what she was thinking or feeling at this moment.
Well, it's quite simple.
Twilight? Celestia looked to her pupil, who instantly perked up hearing her name.
Do you still remember that memory spell from the Discord incident?
Twilight simply nodded as she stood from the couch and hopped up onto the floor. I knew what was going on, what Celestia had in mind. She wanted Twilight to either erase her memories and start from anew, or possibly, I hope she just wanted to give Dashie her memories of her friendship and time in Ponyville. I wasn't sure what to do. I felt it was right. I knew it was right, but and it needed to be done. I had been telling myself that for 15 years as I waited for this moment, but there was something I needed to say before it happened. These ponies were going to take my Dashie away, and I had some words to speak before that could happen.
No, wait, please,
I started. Twilight stopped and looked at the sun goddess.
Just give me a moment with her. Please.
All I ask, since this is the last time we'll see each other. I'd given up holding back my tears, and at this point was openly crying. The ponies could tell I was hurting. Dashie didn't look to be faring too well either. So, figuring it wasn't good to prolong the inevitable, I walked over to the chair Dashie sat in, knelt down to meet her eye level as I spoke.
Dashie,
my little Dashie, I love you with all my heart. You've done wonders to open me up from the man I once was. I had to pause for a moment to settle down. You've brought me so much joy in my life that I can't possibly ever thank you for. At this moment, Dashie too had begun to cry. It only made it worse for me. Those 15 years we had together, talking, playing, flying, all those have been so special to me. I just want you to know that I will forever love you. It doesn't matter if we are biologically related or of different worlds. I don't care what you may ever think of me, or will you ever even remember me. Right now, you being my Dashie, I want you. I poked her in the chest to physically show I was talking to her. To know that fact. If there is ever a problem that happens and you need me, don't hesitate to find a way to get me, okay? I tried to laugh, passing the last part off as a joke. It worked only slightly as we both continued to cry. I could also hear some sniffing from behind me. picture of Pinkie Pie crying as much like she had at the end of the second episode in season one, after Luna and Celestia had reunited.
Do I have to go to Daddy?
It had been a few years since she had actually called me Daddy. Most of the time it was simply Dad or Pops. It felt good knowing she still cared for me enough to call me Daddy. Much like the first time she had said it to me so many years ago, I simply nodded my head as I stood up. Before I could fully grasp my balance, she jumped onto me and hugged me tight. I could feel her tears on the back of my neck. And I returned the embrace. It's your actual home, Dashie. You don't belong here. You need to go back where you belong.
I belong here! With you!
It hurt so much to say, but I had to keep her convinced that this was the right thing to do.
No,
you don't. You're limited here, only able to fly around the house. You have no friends or other ponies to relate to. I was only taking care of you until this time would come, but I never thought it would be this painful. We remained quiet for a few more minutes as we held each other tight. She didn't fight back or want to resist what was happening, which told me she knew as well what must have be done.
I love you, Daddy. I love you too, my little Dashie.
We separated as she lowered herself to the ground. At this point, all the other ponies had tears flowing, even the goddess herself. She had seemed quite smug about knowing what had happened, the time difference and such, but it was evidence that the age difference was a shock. She most likely had to find a 35-year-old Rainbow Dash, but instead found my 20-year-old Dashie. Twilight stepped closer to Rainbow Dash, sniffling once before her horn glowed. I knew what was coming. It hurt so much, but I knew it was right. It was what had to happen for her, for her friends, and in a twisted way for me. Now I could know she was actually going home, and would be around her friends, and could fly wherever and whenever she wanted to, without any limitations. She could enjoy friends' company once more.
Wait!
I looked from the floor to Dashie as she backed away from Twilight.
Before I go, I want to get something.
Before any pony or myself could protest, she flew up to her room. She was quick and returned with a shoebox in her front hoofs. I was unsure if she would be allowed to take anything back with her, and half expected the princess to protest, but she remained quiet, allowing Dashie to quickly write down something on a piece of paper and set it on the coffee table. She looked back to me, still crying, but with a smile on her face. I knew she had realized this was how it must end, and knew I knew that as well. The box, for my guessing, was probably her most cherished item she kept for if she had to leave. Though it hurt me thinking about it, I hoped she had a picture of us. Then again, I also hoped not, for she would be forced to remember me a world away. And that hurt just as much as everything else.
I'm so sorry, Rainbow Dash. Twilight started. I honestly wish there was another way to do this. I wish I didn't have to do this, but...
Dashie started.
Can't he come with me?
The stuttering in her voice told me she was simply speaking her mind, not actually asking the question. Twilight shook her head, unable to keep eye contact with her friend as she cried before her.
Rainbow Dash,
Rainbow Dash, Princess Celestia started. He cannot join you in our world, much like how you cannot stay in his. This was all never meant to be, and the world around us was not made to house you. And yet, Celestia looked to me, smiling, then began to look around our living room. All the photos of us together, all our knickknacks and belongings strewn across the room. And yet, something beautiful happened here. Something I cannot explain in full. When I realized where you ended up, I expected the worst.
I figured you to be ruined, tainted, and tarnished from this world's cruelty. But now, I see it's quite the opposite. That here, this man that has raised you, shows me that you are in good hooves, or hands, as it were. Dashie sniffed once, beginning to calm down as Celestia's work had sunk in. Celestia then returned to looking at me, still smiling.
I cannot speak for you, but from what I see in front of me, the amount of love you both share and have shared together tells me that you raised her as if she was your own. Even with the obvious differences, you still raised her unbiased as to her species, her origins. You raised her as your daughter, which only makes this entire ordeal so much worse. I absorbed her words as well as the other ponies in the room.
So I must say to you, dear sir, please do not hold my student accountable for this. It was never nor any pony else intentions to cause this much hurt to either of you. If you must blame some pony, I would ask you to blame me. I am the one that helped bring them here, to take Rainbow Dash back to her home, away from here. I couldn't look at any of them, my heavy breathing breaking down with sobs. My mind was just going on her own. Thinking back at all the things Dashie and I did together, I took a deep breath as I spoke. Just how could I blame some pony for sending Dashie here? I sniffled, then cleared my throat as I continued. I nearly choked up as I searched for the words to express myself. These have been the best 15 years of my life, so, if anything, I feel quite the opposite. I wish to thank you, Twilight, and the rest of you. Thank you for what you did, though not intentional. Thank you for all that came out of this. And finally, thank you for all my years, my life, and my love with Dashie. I tried to smile at Twilight between the sobs, but she looked on the edge of tears herself. I could only look away before she cried herself. Celestia then stood from the rug she had laid on and walked over to me as I stood.
No need for thanks, good sir. Instead, I wish to thank you for taking care of one of my little ponies. She would have never made it without someone much like yourself.
Celestia closed her eyes and then leaned her horn toward me. I didn't move. I wasn't sure what was going on as she touched her horn to my head. I felt a sudden warmth rush through my body. She drew her horn away, still smiling as she stepped back.
Thank you.
Then another pony spoke up.
Thank you, sir.
Twilight added, finally able to speak through her tears.
Thank you,
Applejack said.
Thank you, darling, for caring for Rainbow Dash,
Reddy spoke.
Thank you.
Very shy, quietly said,
thanks!
Reddy and Pinkie Pie shouted as she sprung up to me and hugged me. I couldn't help but laugh a little from her eccentric attitude. Better yet, the rumors on the internet were true. Her mane did smell like cotton candy. I remained silent as I nodded. Then looked back to Dashie, who also wore a smile on her face. The ponies all returned to Dashie as Twilight's horn began to glow once more.
Are you ready now, Rainbow Dash?
Twilight asked again, returning to Dashie and starting her magic. She simply nodded as she closed her eyes and awaited the inevitable. It seemed time slowed as Twilight's horn approached Dashie's forehead. My mind began forcing random memories of us together. I can vividly remember the splashing of the bathtub from her bath times before she showered herself. I can still taste our many failed attempts at baking and cooking in general. I still smell the outdoors from our times at the park, where she was able to spread her wings. There were so many memories that I simply had to shut off my brain so I could keep focused on Dashie. A single tear ran down her left cheek as I could see her eyes moving under her lids. Her mind was doing the same thing as mine was, forcing our fondest memories all at once. This would be the last time we ever saw one another. Finally, Twilight's horn touched Dashie's forehead. There was a bright light, and when I could see again, they were all gone. All the ponies had disappeared. Through my tears, I sighed in relief. It felt wrong, but it also felt right.
She was now the normal Rainbow Dash, that blonde in Ponyville. I stood in the living room for several more minutes, just staring blankly at the empty floor that Dashie had been standing at just moments ago. Then, I looked around the room and took notice of my surroundings. I noticed things were different. Pictures that once held images of me and Dashie no longer hung from the walls. Many of the random personal items of hers were scattered around the living room were gone as well. I was confused, so I ran up to her bedroom to look. When I opened the door, what I saw instead of her NASCAR and air show posters mixed with her bed and other furnishings was a simple office. A cheap desk with a computer on it and an ugly-looking potted plant. It took me some time to digest what I was experiencing before I realized what must have happened. It made sense, but stuck in my chest. To make sure nothing happened between worlds, Celestia must have removed any existence of Dashie ever being here. Being with me, 15 years, all down the drain as her existence was wiped from the planet. I felt as though all these years were for naught, wasted as I wouldn't be able to remember her. And yet, my memory still lingered on her. I could still remember everything as if it were as vivid as when they happened. Then the thought clicked. She did something with her magic when she touched me with her horn. Did she protect my memories so that I would remember her? Had she done the same for Dashie? I walked back downstairs and into the living room while I thought. On the coffee table sat a book. I recognized it. It was my photo album. I sat down on my couch, opened it up to the first page. There was my mother and father, with me shortly after I was born. I continued to flip through them, looking at my own. There was a gap after my parents died, but to keep my mother's dream going, I had picked it back up. Making false pictures of happy times and enjoying my life to stick into her book of memories. Then I opened up to a piece of paper. I picked it up and immediately recognized the handwriting, or more correct, mouth writing. I speculated this was what she had written down before she left.
Dad, for 15 years you took care of me. For 15 years you loved me, played with me, and made sure I enjoyed my life in a world that was not meant to house me. I'm not a man of many words, but even though I told you this in person, I feel you needed a written version of it so you know it was all real. I love you, Daddy. You helped shape me into the man I am now. I'm not sure of what is going to happen, if I'll remember any of this or not, but I want you to know that you did a darn good job of raising me. Even if I was a bit stubborn and short with you during others, with Celestia's permission, I hope to allow you to keep our photos, our memories, with you so that you never forget. Again, I love you, and thank you. Your little daughter always, your little Dashie forever. Rainbow Dash. I set the note back into the page, flattening it with my hand as I felt the dried tear markings littering the page. I read the note over and over and over again until I had it memorized. Then I turned the page and was greeted with Dashie's Philly smile. So now I sit here, looking through my photo album of our time together. Her first bath, her first words, her first drawing, even her first preened feather. All this in the book of memories. Everything else in the house is gone, but what I had put into this book still remains. I don't dare ever change that either, but I will continue to add to it, to show that those years with her helped not only shape herself, but helped shape me as well. I'm a new man from what I was years ago. Changed, given another chance by a sheer miracle of fortunate events that transpired from somewhere I can't even speculate. If I had never gone back and checked that box, if I had done something different than I had, could have changed everything between us. I guess I'm lucky that it all worked out. I can gladly say that I have achieved my parents' only wish, for me to be happy. Though I'm saddened, I'm still happy for the time I had with her. I now sit alone in this empty house, staring at my mother's rainbow picture with a smile plastered on my face. Every time I see it, I think of Dashie. I should be crying. I should feel horrible and want nothing but my daughter back. And yet, I feel relieved to know that everything is all right.
She didn't run away or leave on bad terms. She's gone, home, to where she belongs, and is safe. I look back down to my photo album, turn to the page after her most recent photo. The pages are blank. I still have a lot of life ahead of me. I plan to make the best of it. For myself. For my little Dashie. The end. That was a very, very good story. Anyway, guys, I'm not really sure how to close this one. I don't usually do, like I stated at most of my dramatic readings, I don't usually do this. I like to keep my channel variety, so it's not just one thing, but I tend to keep it just Let's Plays mostly. I do other things like ranting or doing dramatic readings, obviously. I've also considered doing some singing a cappella and adding my own instrumental versions to them, like doing covers or whatever. But if you want, you can check out some of my other stuff, some of my rants, some of my like Let's Plays. I have done Cave Story. There's a long list on my channel of what I've done, what I haven't done. If you want, you can check that out. Subscribe to me if you like me. Leave a comment in the comment below on what you think that I can improve, like with my voice or whatever. But anyway, guys, this has been a really touching story. This has been My Little Dashie. Anyway, guys, this is Mr. Mav 96 at 3:08 a.m. signing out. I'm going to go get some sleep. See you guys next time.